sister?
Killing swine. Sister, where thou?
A sailor's wife had chestnuts in her lap, and munched and munched and munched. Give me, quoth I, arise thee, witch, thee rump-fed roaring cries. Her husband's to Aleppo gone, master o' the tiger, but in a scene I'll thither sail, and like a rat without a tail, I'll do, and I'll do.
I'll give thee a wind.
Thou art kind.
And I another.
I myself have all the other, and the very ports they blow, all the quarters that they know, I the shipman's card. I will drain him dry as hay, sleep shall neither night nor day, hang upon his penthouse lid, he shall live a man forbid. Weary sin mites, nine times nine, shall he dwindle, peak and pine. Though his bark cannot be lost, yet it shall be tempest tossed. Look what I have.
Show me.
Here I have a pilot's thumb, wrecked as homeward he did come.
A drum, Macbeth doth come.
The weird sisters hand in hand, posters of the sea and land, thus do go about, thrice to thine and thrice to mine, and thrice again to make up nine. Peace, the charms wound up.
So foul and fair a day I had not seen.
How far is it called the forest? What are these, so withered and so wild in their attire, that look not like the inhabitants of the earth? And yet, are aunt live you, or are you aught that man may question? You seem to understand me, by each at once her chappy finger laying upon her skinny lips. You should be women, and yet your beards forbid me to believe, interpret that you are so.
Speak, if you can. What are you?
All hail, Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Glamis!
All hail, Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Cawdor!
All hail, Macbeth! Thou shalt be king hereafter!
Good sir, why do you start and seem to fear things that do not sound so fair? I, the name of truth, are ye fantastical, or that indeed which outwardly ye show, my noble partner? You greet with present grace and great prediction of noble having and royal hope. That seems half withal to me, you speak not. If you can look into the seeds of time and say which grain will grow and which will not, speak then to me, who neither beg nor fear your favors nor your hate.
Hail!
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 Lesser than Macbeth and greater.
Not so happy, yet much happier.
Thou shalt get kings, though thou be none. So all hail Macbeth and Banquo!
Banquo and Macbeth, all hail!
Stay, you imperfect speakers, tell me more. By Sinel's death, I know I am Thane of Glamis. But how of Cawdor? The Thane of Cawdor lives, a prosperous gentleman, and to be king stands not within the prospect of belief. No more than to be Cawdor, say from whence you owe this strange intelligence, or why, upon this blasted heath, you stop our way with such prophetic greeting. Speak, I charge you.
The earth hath bubbles, as the water has, and these are of them. Whither are they vanished?
Into the air, and what seemed corporal melted, as breath in the wind, where they hath stayed.
Were such things here as do we speak about, or have we eaten on the insane root that takes the reason prisoner?
Your children shall be kings.
You shall be king.
And Thane of Cawdor too, when it not so?
To the selfsame tune and words, who's he?